Hey everyone. Yesterday when I was editing the vlog, I realized that the video from this GoPro was a little bit grainy, which often happens when your ISO gets bumped up too high, when the camera's trying to compensate for the environment being a little bit too dark. And the easiest way to deal with that is adding more light. Because GoPro, not as fancy as something like an ATD where you get to manually change everything. The GoPro just like, it's very automatic. It does everything for you, which is why it's such a cool camera. Okay, so today I'm gonna throw on this little toy of mine. It's a little battery powered light by Dracast. This I sometimes will throw on top of my DSLR if I'm shooting video or photos in a dark environment, but this I can put on the center mount on the GorillaPod, and it'll provide a whole bunch of extra light in environments where we need it. So I'm going to quickly do that and I'll be back in a second. And we're back. Okay, so I've now got the GoPro next to the light, next to the microphone, and I can see there's a whole lot more light coming at me, so it's very nice and clear. And the cool thing is with this Dracast light, bumping the microphone, is that I can adjust the brightness over quite a range, so depending on how much light you need. Okay, this is plenty there. I can also adjust the color temperature of it, so depending on how you want the scene to feel. Okay, I'm just previewing this on my phone. Cool little feature of the GoPro. Okay, I tend to prefer this on more of a cool white setting, more of a daylight, 56 Kelvin, or 5600 Kelvin setting. And yeah, so that's the upgrade to the GoPro vlogging rig for today. But I think that's about all the changes I'm probably going to need for that for the month, really. That should do it. And I think on with the vlogging for the month. Yeah. Today is the 4th. I've taken Pi to work. I've just had some breakfast and finished my morning tea. And time for me to get some exercise. I'm not usually one for exercise, but I'm trying to get better at it. And the simplest way for me to do that is to make it fun. I do enjoy Nordic walking, but that usually involves having a group of people, and the Cape Town Nordic walking group is kind of on pause at the moment because the organizer is recovering from some surgery. So Hugh, I hope you get better soon. Also, Pa's at work, so I can't go with her. So I'm going to resort to my other favorite form of exercise, which is Just Dance. I've got Just Dance now on my computer, which lets me use my phone as a controller. And I'll give you a little snippet of that now. I'm a little bit of a I think that's enough work had for now. Time for a shower. So, this fridge is Pa's beer fridge. Okay. It's been here for about a month now. Yeah. We bought this fridge because her craft beer collection is sitting in my fermentation chamber, which is a big deep freeze, which I've got a temperature regulation set up on, which is in the room next door. But at the moment, it's got all the beer in there, so I can't actually use it for making mead. So this has been sitting here for about a month, but we've actually been too busy to transfer all the beer into it. And right now, it's got 7 beers in it. So I'm gonna move all Pa's beer into here so that I can actually start making some mead in my fermentation chamber again. And yeah, I'm gonna let you guys see all that happening. Here is a look at Pies. So, this was a relatively cheap little fridge. We got it from Hirsch. Fridges are not the cheapest items to buy, but this one is not your standard bar fridge. It's bigger than a normal bar fridge, but smaller than a normal kitchen fridge. So it's in that like in-between area, but you get more space than a normal bar fridge. So it's a bit more economical, but it's a bit more value for money and that. I think it looks better as well. It's nice and quiet. That was one of our big concerns, is it sits right here next to our computer desks. If it's going to be right next to where we work all the time, it needs to be quiet. So yeah, and it's pretty. It's nice and red. It does have this ice water feature on the front, although we haven't actually made use of that yet. But it's a nice to have for summer. We're going into winter at the moment, so not really a have to have. But it's nice that it's there for when summer comes around again. But yeah, it's a nice little addition to our office lounge area, and Pi can keep her collection all nice and cool and arranged and with an easy reach. So that's all there. She can now rearrange to her heart's desires there, but all of her stuff is now there for her if she wants to rearrange it to whatever Dewey Decimal or whatever the beer geek standards are these days. Not being a beer geek myself, I'm not sure, but I'm sure she'll geek out about that on her own vlog. Anyway, I'm going to try and see what I can do about this this growler. As much as this is a really nice growler, we got this from Ager Project. It's a really pretty growler. It's hydro flask. I think we just ended up getting a little bit of beer in the thread of this, and it got all sticky, and now we can't get it open. So I'm gonna have to try and see if I can get enough torque on this or dissolve the sugar, or maybe this went on skew, I don't know. But either way, this needs to come off because it's leaking, and leaking beer is not good. So next project. Okay, folks. Okay. I've spent a bit of time doing some tutorials on DaVinci Resolve's Fusion tool, and then Resolve crashed on me and didn't save my work, which was a bit annoying, even though I had live save turned on, which is frustrating. But anyway, I've also just had dinner, which was very tasty, but it is now 8:30, and I think I'm going to edit this vlog, get that posted, and then go and climb into bed, get an early night, and we can get a good start on tomorrow. So, hope you all had a good day, and we'll see you again tomorrow. Cheers for now. Bye.